a song in Olajuwon, okay? Her song just gave Olajuwon, okay, 400,000 naira just for dancing to his new song called Cha Cha. So if you're the type that likes free money, free giveaways, just go do a video of you dancing. Could be 30 seconds or 1 minute. Just do it, post it on your Instagram account, and then tag Harry's song. If he likes it, definitely you get something. He's doing this giveaway like every Friday. So if you post a video and then he likes it, definitely he will reach out to you. So you guys might be wondering, who is Olajuwon? Well, Olajuwon is the lady who was once a bread seller who turned celebrity. Not just any celebrity, a celebrity model. Now I believe you guys know the lady I'm talking about. So I'm going to be showing you the dance to Harry's song's latest single, Cha Cha. Here's the video. If you want to do yours, you're free. The free giveaway is still going on. And here we have B-Red. B-Red recently, in this interview, he disclosed a lot of things. He talked about a lot of things about how he struggled to get to where he is now. Not just himself alone, him and Davido. He talked about how they moved from the US to Nigeria, how they were inspired by the Moe hits, talking about Don Jazzy and the Bunch. So I'm going to be showing you some clips of the interview. He also talked about people criticizing him, telling him that he's jealous of his own cousin Davido. So he had some few words for you guys, those of you who think that he's jealous of his own brother. So here's the video.
But funny enough, you know, in America and Nigeria, some people they still confuse me for them. See Davido, I'm like, bro, how do I look like? He said, no, you look like yellow Davido. All even my voice, my daddy has the same voice as me. So people think that I'm trying to do the voice like that.
Well, that's true. That's family. But how do you handle comparison with Davido? I'm sure this is something that you know has dogged you your whole
career. In what kind of way? What do you mean comparison?
Comparison is like, okay, now let's see, B-Red is coming up. Davido is coming. Davido is like, it's really big now. Yeah. Then B-Red is coming up.
Still coming up.
Yeah, how do you
how I feel about this? Davido is my younger cousin.
Oh, you're older?
Yeah, I'm older. Okay. But he's older in, you understand? But funny enough, I'm very happy for my cousin. Many people think that I'll be jealous of my cousin because I'm older. No, this is a family. It's a family, you understand? As he's getting bigger, me too, I'm getting bigger because I'm his family, you know, okay. So automatically. So I'm happy for him. When I was in America last week, I was in Miami, Bahamas, and ATL. Every time I enter the car, Davido, I'm like, wow, this is crazy. So it's a blessing from God because as we're in the same family when we move together.
So the blessing he's getting is rubbing off.
It's a rub off for me, yeah. So, like I said, new single dropping. Achieve,
so the blessings are
with a rubber of small.
Definitely, the blessings are all around. And
your career
has moved this fast. And would you say it's because you had the backing of like your family behind you?
Like
and
I said,
had money.
Like I said before.
Okay.
When we first started, for the first year, they didn't help us.
Oh, okay.
So we like stop doing music. You understand? Okay. So it was David that told me, like, see, when you dropped the first backwear with Leto, so he said, David said, can I remember this HKN tattoo?
Yeah.
David has this thing, HKN tattoo on his hand. We got it to my mom's garage over 9 years ago. And I was telling him, Omo, let's not put this thing here. David said, trust me, we will blow. I said, are you sure? He said, I will make sure.
Okay.
And God just put it through.
God just put it through. So it's not just the money and everything.
No.
It's
we actually
hustle.
Many people think, oh, you people are just rich. You just paid your... No, we actually had to hustle. I remember... If I start talking.
No, it's fine.
I remember when I first moved back to Nigeria, my family didn't want to do music. I only had like two shirts and like two boxers and one jeans. Like I was staying in a Paco house with one of my workers now. Like I'm serious, like I didn't have no money.
Okay.
Until like my parents and people started helping me.
So what this Paco house now, can you remember where it was?
Yes. Waterside Lekki. Yeah.
Waterside Lekki?
Yes.
No fun, nothing.
Nothing. Sometimes I'll just call my friend, I'll say, Omo, nowhere to go. We'll just come there, sleep for like 5 hours, wake up, waterside, beach front, then continue the next day.
So, looking at you.
Even in America, before I came back to Nigeria, I was terribly broke.
Okay.
And you know how Nigerians are, if you don't go to school, you know where else
you okay.
So we started, because you know, everybody wants to do music, you know? So it's very hard. So you have to, you know, like, well, you can't go and tell your parents you want to do music if you're not really sure you're going to make it. So you have to prove them wrong to me. Now I'm doing shows around the world.
How many years have you been in the
Well, that's a very good question because myself, I don't even know. No, but basically when I started in the industry, I started off hyping my cousin Davido.
Okay.
I went to like over 20 different countries, hyping him over the world.
So that's, before you even started
singing,
your own?
Yes, yeah. So okay. That's how I even built my fame.
Okay.
I'm just being in my cousin's videos and just hyping him all over the world. So after that, I started singing. So from there.
And then, so let's put a number to it now. So let's say 6, 7, 8, 9.
I'll say 6 years.
6 years?
Yeah, 6 years.
6 years in the game, really, and see how far you've come.
Push.
So at what point, before you even started hyping,
yeah.
At what point did you decide that music was your thing?
Since the age of six.
Six.
I play drum, I'm a professional drummer.
Okay.
I play any kind of drum sets. I mainly play drum sets. Okay. When I was in a school in America, I used to control the marching band like two of my high schools, Roswell High School and Duluth High School. I started playing in churches like Fountain of Light Church in Lupeju, different churches around the world in London, America. So I started making money off playing drums in churches and stuff. So that's when in America, my brother Shino Rambo and David had a group called KB International, which David was just the engineer.
Well, he wasn't even singing.
The engineer. My main first time, David said, your voice, bad. Start to the scene, the accent.
Okay.
That's how we first started then. Like, we're going back to the jazz and movies.
Okay.
Me and my brother Shino Rambo, we used to always pick up the movies when they come for tour in America. So we'd be like, they're doobie boys. We didn't mind, because we were their biggest fans.
Yeah.
So we picked them every time over the years, like 3 years. So one of the years they came by, me, David, and Shonama picked them up. It's like, man, you guys should come back to Nigeria. You guys are talented. We'll support. Come on, let's do it.
Because you didn't even
enter. So that's how it all started.
That's how you
shout out to the Moritz crew.
Now that you're doing music.
The next news is about Benue State. Something bad is really happening in Benue State right now, which I don't like. I'm so angry because this is a sad and also an annoying news. Because you can't just be killing people just because you want power. Killing innocent people. The incident that took place in Benue State led to the killing of 11 people, and we are getting report now that about 40 people are still missing. You get, the incident is said to be a fallout of the rivalry between two communities, like two neighboring villages, and the local government area of Benue State. Like, one part is trying to tell the other that they are more powerful than the other tribe. One tribe is trying to tell the other tribe that we are more powerful than you. So for this, if the first tribe decided to kill 10 people, and then the other tribe returned and then killed 11, and hunting, 40 people are also missing. It's really bad because our government is doing nothing about this issue. It's really annoying. How can you just be killing people just because you want power? There are other things you can do. Like, I don't get it. Why will you kill somebody just to prove to people that you're far more better than others when there are other things you can do? Why not create a good business? Why not create something better? Do something nice to prove others that you're better than them. Not take lives, innocent lives. It's really not nice. And to make the whole issue worse, the government of Nigeria is doing nothing about this. Now Buhari is not saying anything. The government is doing nothing. It's really, really annoying. Please, this is my new channel. Please try and support me. So right now, I'm going to leave you guys with this, with all that I've said. If you have anything you want to say, please do leave a comment down below. And if you think I've done something wrong, please support me. Leave a comment down below. If you feel like you really enjoyed it, give it a thumbs up. And if you think that the video sucks, give it a thumbs down. Either way, it's accepted. Keeps me motivated to do more videos. Until we see you again.